Good morning and welcome to StudyIQ. I am Prashant Mavani. I hope you are having a good day, friends. Today is 10th November. It's Saturday, so we don't have that many articles to go through. In fact, we have just three articles that are important for your examination. Now, this one, the algebra of opposition, if you have extra time, then yes, you can go through it, or else you can completely ignore this article. It's a pure political article, not important for your examination. We are going to go through three articles. One is this cause to remain alert. This one is about Zika. In whose name? This is about this, you know, this change of names that we are finding in various different cities and districts or maybe states. So we are going to ask a couple of questions about it. And then you have this beyond criticism. It's about a film it's a film called Sarkar. And it's a film from Tamil Nadu film industry, and you have this famous superstar called Vijay, and his film is out, and there are people out there who are opposing this film. So many interesting things from this editorial as well. Now, before we jump on to this discussion on Zika, I would like to remind all of you that today is the last date of this big Diwali sale. Make the most out of it. Check out studyiq.com. To find out more about it, and if you have any question or queries, then feel free and give us a call on the numbers that you can see on your screen. From my side, I would like to say that this is the biggest discount that you can ever get, and the next discount will be next year. So you'll not get this big discount. So if you haven't got our pen drive and tablet course, and if you're thinking about it, then today is the last date. Now, let's start with some basic understanding about Zika. Most people get Zika from a mosquito bite. So here you can see a person, right? A mosquito bites a person infected with Zika virus. Now, a mosquito becomes infected. A mosquito will, generally speaking, live in a single house during its lifetime. Then other family members are exposed to Zika, and they will be traveling to various different places. So a few other mosquitoes will get affected by it. And then people are traveling at workplaces and other places. So other people will get affected by Zika. So this is one of the most common way or the most common reason behind the spread of Zika. Apart from that, you have during pregnancy, mother to fetus and then or a newborn baby. Then you have during sex as well as through blood transfusion. So these are some less common ways how people or the reason why people get Zika. Now, last time when Zika was in news, I'm talking about international global news, it was back in 2014 and a little bit in 2015 and then in 2016. It all started here in Africa, Uganda, 1947. The first documented Zika virus in monkeys in Uganda, and after that in 60s we find first human case in Nigeria. Then later on in our country, India, Pakistan, Malaysia, Indonesia, these Asian countries. And in 2007, it was in Micronesia, that is this country's here. And then in 2013, it was in French Polynesia. And it was a big outbreak right here in this portion or this part of the world, Mexico and Central Asia, Brazil and all the South American nations were affected by Zika. And it was a big global thing, because just a couple of years before this Zika, we were facing this Ebola in this part, and so many people you were affected by Ebola. Ebola was again a deadly disease, and this one too is a matter of concern, because the thing is this microcephaly, it's a rare neurological condition characterized by underdeveloped brains and undersized heads. So what happens with a newborn is that a newborn will you have a small, generally this is our normal head, this black outline that you can see here. And a person or a baby affected with this microcephaly will have a small head, a very weird or very, you can say, different shape from normal head. It will be very small in size as well. And of course, right, there are no chances at all that the baby will survive. So this is the biggest problem with Zika, right? The biggest threat is this thing, particularly to newborn babies. And all Zika virus strain could possibly cause birth defects. So this is a thing that we have to take into consideration. Now, in this article, we find a case of Jaipur, right? That is, of course, in our state called Rajasthan. So there was a statement by Indian Council of Medical Research that Zika virus strains causing the outbreak in Jaipur, Rajasthan cannot cause microcephaly. Now, this is a matter of concern, and the reason why we need to be a bit worried about, or we should be afraid, we should have this fear in our hearts and minds about this microcephaly is because at present we don't know exactly how it causes birth defects. Now, interesting thing about this or unique thing about this Zika is that some people are okay with Zika. If they are affected by Zika, then they will not show any sign at all. And there will be minor fever and rashes and things like that. And after that, they will be all right. Some are mildly affected and some are severely affected. So why we have various different people or various different, you know, people in different region impact, or within a region as well, you find that impact of Zika is different on different people. So this is a very interesting, or very, you know, it generates this curiosity, of course, that why this thing is behaving in such a weird way. So we need to find the proper answer for this thing. Right, and this statement of Indian Council of Medical Research is a bit early as per this article, as per this, you know, finding of the person who has written this article, because, of course, much more research is needed to determine if some strains are associated with higher risks. We cannot take chances. The other thing is, just imagine all those people, right, who are having just mild, you can say mild, they show mild symptoms of Zika or normal fever, but actually they are affected by Zika. And as I told you that, let's say we have X, Y, and Z. So X, right, nothing happens to X, Y is mildly affected, and Z is severely affected. So we don't know still whether if a mosquito bites X gets affected, and then that mosquito bites Y, and then gets affected, and then this mosquito or some other mosquito will bite Z, and Z will get severe form of Zika, or it could be direct as well. So research is required, and there are so many people like X, right? They are not registered, or they are we haven't counted them as Zika affected patients. So impact of Zika could be much more severe than what we are estimating at present. The best thing that we can do is stay alert, right? We have to take all the precautions and wearing full sleeves and using mosquito repellent and mosquito nets and keeping our environment clean, you know, making sure that there are no potholes with filled up with water and tiny little, you know, puddles and things like that. And family planning as well. All those all those couples out there, you know, if they are planning to have a baby, and if they are living in this Zika affected region, then they should you know, delay it for time being because of this microcephaly. So this are some of the things that we need to do about Zika. I'm sure it's going to be it was an easy discussion, isn't it? Now we are going to talk about in whose name. And this in whose name, right, at present, we can assume this thing, right, that map maker are quite busy, as well as there are a few BJP people out there. They are busy too, because they are finding, you know, names of various different places and cities. And they are, I'm just kidding, map makers are busy because UPCM, Yogi Adityanath, is one by one, you know, he's changing names of various different places, like Mughal Sarai Junction, one of the most busiest, you can say, India's busiest railway junctions, was renamed to honor Deen Dayal Upadhyay. Now Allahabad is now Prayagraj. Faizabad district is Ayodhya district. And this is not just something that is taking place in Uttar Pradesh. Recently, Deputy Chief Minister of Gujarat, Nitin Patel, has said that Ahmedabad will be renamed as Karnavati. Now, Karnavati was a sort of medieval name of Ahmedabad, and then later on it was changed to Ahmedabad. From Karnavati it became Ahmedabad and things like that. So now the most common thing that we can find here is, of course, BJP, isn't it? Both these states are ruled by BJP. Now, I'm not blaming BJP, right? And I'm not afraid of blaming BJP, but I don't want to enter into that game because that's not going to create any sort of logic. It will be more emotional whether we like BJP or whether we like Congress or whether we like X party or Y party or things like that. So rather than that, right, we can think about some important, or we can look at this particular thing from various different angles. So I am going to provide you some food for thought here, and I will leave it on you guys to decide, right? First of all, let's talk about this mixed cultural heritage of our country. The basic question is, do we have a mixed cultural heritage? Yes or no? If no, then why not? And if yes, then what are some of the points that you can highlight, like in food, in way of living, in way of, say, for example, visiting various different religious places. So how it impacts our tourism, how it impacts our food, our clothing, you know, our fashion. There are so many things, our construction, right, our language, our script. So mixed culture, impact of mixed culture on our day-to-day life. There are so many things that I believe we are not even paying attention to because it is so common. So many words that we use in Hindi language, say for example, are coming from Arabic, are coming from Parsi. So many food items are coming from. So if we go through our history, we find that our country has always welcomed, you know, ideas, new ideas. If you have a new idea, then you can come to India, because India was a land of universities. It was a land of religion and religion as well. If I tell you, say for example, if I tell you history of Gujarat, then we have so many examples, you know, rich examples where Muslim rulers, right, they have helped in construction of temples. And it was other way around as well, like many Hindu rulers, they have granted money for construction of mosques. As far as I know, right, all these wars were not based on religion. It was more based on politics, right? It was based on necessity of kingdom. It was more military necessity. And we were talking about this, remember, this Shia versus Sunni. We were talking about this Iran and Saudi Arabia. And at that point of time, I told you this thing, that the most visible thing is religion, right? That's the most visible thing. And unfortunately, there are people out there, and I'm not talking about, again, any particular political party. This is something that you find all across the board, from North India to South India, from East India to West India. And it's not just something that is limited in India, right? Around the world, right, politicians who are trying to woo voters, they will use everything, you know, that is there, every trick in the book to make sure that they are there in the minds as well as hearts of people, particularly during election time. Now, there is one more question that we need to ask is it destruction of our cultural heritage, or the name, the change of name is something that reflects our cultural heritage? Because Prayagraj was an ancient name, and then later on in medieval era it became Allahabad, and now we are changing it to Prayagraj. So what's right for our country, right? Then is it that one particular community is been given greater you can say support, and one particular community is basically not given support at all? Is it something that we are finding in our society, right? Is it something that has been done by government, or is it something that is done by political parties? Because here you have a very fine line, right? The line is, say, government is run by politicians. Now, when you are just a political party, if you are not in power, then you can do whatever you like because you are not in power. But once your party is in power, then you become, you know, it's your responsibility. Now, your party is part of government, and government itself should be impartial. Government cannot take sides, right? It has to stick with only one side, and that is truth. And it is allowed to stick with truth. It is allowed to stick with constitution. It is allowed to stick with rules and regulations. Apart from that, there is no best friend of government. Government has to follow. Government has to work like a lighthouse. But when it comes to political parties' interest, unfortunately, not in all cases, I must add here, but in few cases, we do find that political interests are given top priority compared to what is right for the people and what is. Now, the thing is, if Yogi Adityanath ji has changed name of a particular city, then is he doing something illegal or something that is part of his right or his authority? If he's doing it legally, then what's wrong in it, right? Or is he doing it to create or woo voters? So there are so many things, right, that from various different angles you can look at this particular thing, because it's not just this case, right? Now we are finding this thing that new demand in Ahmedabad, or a new signal is coming from Gujarat. In near future, we can find some signals from some other places. Now, this is not the first time, right? Kanpur became Kanpur, Madras became Chennai, Bombay became Mumbai, and there are other places as well. So it's not the first time we are witnessing this thing, but why we are giving this much, you know, emphasis on names? Whether it is necessary or not at all necessary, I leave it on you guys to decide. Right, moving on to another item, beyond criticism. Now, this beyond criticism is about, it's not just about a book or a film. It's about freedom of expression. And freedom of expression is something that is very basic. If I allow everything, right, if you say, for example, you might have observed this thing in a family that they allow you everything, or kids in that family, they are given best cars and best phones and, you know, most expensive, when I say best, everything, food, cloth, whatever they want, everything is well. But one thing is not allowed, and that is to speak in the house. When I say speak in the house, I mean to say that when family members, particularly elders, are there, they have to be in their best behavior. These kids have to be in their best behavior. They cannot even pick up their mobile phones. I'm not sure how many of you have seen this sort of families, but I have. And I know one thing, that from outside, one may think that this family or these kids have got everything. When I say kids, I'm not talking about small kids. It could be 18, 19, teenagers, or maybe in their early 20s. So it looks like they have got every luxury and every happiness that one can aspire for. But it also, you know, somewhere deep down, they have this vacuum, a vacuum of freedom. They don't have that freedom. And freedom is something that is very important, right? It's very basic. So it's a thing. It's just like health. When we are healthy, we don't appreciate health. But when we are not well, when we fall sick, at that point of time, we value in the same way. If someone is thrown behind the bars, then at that point of time, that person will realize how important freedom is. So freedom of expression is something that is very basic. It is part of our fundamental right as well. And here we find that filmmakers are many times, filmmakers or writers, they become victim of this bullying. And most of the time, this bullying is conducted by political parties or this sort of political groups. At present, we are finding a film called Sarkar. It's a Tamil film, and in this film, they have got some scenes or some sort of, the story includes a lady called, who is resembling Jayalalitha, and there are some images or a scene where this fire, these mixtures and other grinders and other things are destroyed, and people are burning it and things like that. So the ruling party is saying that you are defaming our late leader Jayalalitha, And the Fisheries Minister D. Jayakumar has said that filmmakers have lost their fears. So that's a sort of open, you can say, threat issued by political parties. We have seen this sort of things many a times in various different with books as well, with films as well. And politicians, right, they are very good. Particularly, I'm not saying any ruling party or this is something that you find in politicians. They have this ability to exploit your fear, right? They know exactly how to use this fear in their favor. So when you it's very natural, because all of us as human beings, we used to live in tribes, so we have this attachment and this identity of something that is very deep down us. So identity, now every single day we switch these hats, right, every day. But there are a few identities that are very deep, like caste identity, then religion identity, nationality, regionality, and male, female. There are a few identities, they are very deep down us. So when someone will create this, if I can generate a fear in you that one of your core identity is under threat, then that will create, this fear will create, it will prepare your body as well as your mind for a battle. So this is how it works. I'm talking about some psychological level of human behavior. Now, we also find that youngsters who are protesting, if you are not happy with something, say, for example, then you can protest. But if you're asking filmmakers and book writers to cut down some of a portion of their story, then that is not fair, because we have Central Board of Film Certification. And once a film is certified by this Central Board of Film Certification, then you cannot do anything about it, technically speaking, ideally. But the Central Board of Film Certification is also known as Censor Board. And Censor Board, the word itself means that it is going to cut down, or it's a body that is there to chop your items. So that's not at all right, because the main job of Central Board is to give you a certificate whether a film is an adult film or whether it is a UA film or a 18 plus film, or 14 year old kid can see this film with parents. And so all these various categories you have, we are not going into technical details of these categories, but the thing is, if you have a body, a Central Board of Film Certification, if that film has cleared this film, release of this film, or if that film has given this film a certificate, then there should be no one in our nation to stop this film. Courts have repeatedly emphasized, but on the grounds, things are a bit on grassroots level, or on ground, we find that things are a bit different. Now, Tamil Nadu, we find that this culture of cult fan following and social issues are discussed in commercial cinema less than in political arena. And you have this five chief ministers of Tamil Nadu, they had this film industry background. So films play a very important role in the cultural life of Tamil Nadu. And now we have to wait and watch on this thing, like what's going to take place on this. Now we have get in this, we get this thing from front page of the Hindu, that makers of Sarkar effect cuts for truce. So a compromise between political ruling party and this filmmaker has been reported in the first page of the Hindu newspaper. So again, this is a thing that you can analyze this particular item from various different angles, whether what's we have Central Board, then what Supreme Court is doing, whether this is something that is possible, then from practical side, what happens in real world, what about these threats and other things that's coming from ruling party, what will you do if you were there in place of that producer. So there are so many things that you can ask on this particular item. Now we are heading towards, or we reach here in this news section, important news. Sirisena dissolves Sri Lanka parliament polls. Parliament polls on 5th January 2019, government denies move to seek 3.6 lakh crore from RBI. It's about this RBI versus government issue that's going on. Subhash Chandra Garg, secretary, has said that a lot of misinformation or misinformed speculation is going around. There is no proposal to ask RBI to transfer 3.6 lakh crore as speculated. HAL, that is Hindustan Aeronautical Limited, has cleared, or it's HTT-40, the indigenously built basic trainer aircraft, on Friday cleared challenging milestone. Its first spin test, which is first baby step, it's not the final, but it's a good start. That we have India to export sugar to China. We have some surplus stock of sugar, and we are going to sell it to China and later on to Indonesia and Malaysia as well. Raw sugar is second product after non-basmati rice that China will import from India. New team of wildlife expert to probe killing of tigress. Avni Alok Verma Asthana appears before CVC. CVC is supposed to place its findings in a sealed cover, and it will be handed over to Supreme Court on Monday. Not in direct talks with Taliban. We talked about this thing yesterday. I told you this is a very interesting thing that's going on. So India has clarified, Ministry of External Affairs has clarified, that we are not directly associating ourselves or engaging with Taliban. It's just we'll be there, we'll participate, or we'll, you know, we'll unofficially participate here. Modi to attend Maldives new president's swearing in 70. This indicates a new era of India and Maldives relationship. Credit growth at 5-year high. When people are seeking money or seeking loan, that means that they are ready to invest, and this is a very good indication. Farm to foreign land. Niti Aayog argues against restrictions on agri product. The thing is that many times, say for example, sugar at present, rough example, 50 rupees per kilo in India, but in international market, its worth is 200 kilo rupees per kilo. So farmers can earn extra 150 rupees here. But when you are keeping restrictions on exports on this sort of items, then we miss this opportunity. Now, you have on your screen infographic of M777 Ultra Light Howitzer, made by USA, used by India. And we have this K9 Vajra T gun, made by South Korea. We purchased this thing from them. So these are two items. You can download the PDF of today's lecture, and you can, of course, go through it. These are some of your vocabs. Make sure you post your meanings of this vocabs in the comment section of this video. Yesterday I asked you a question about a place, so this is Hong Kong, and one of the reasons why it is in news is because Financial Times, a very important, very famous newspaper of UK, and this FT's journalist was not allowed to enter China. On your screen you have a picture, so can you tell me what this picture is all about? You can download the PDF of today's lecture from my IBPS Twitter handle. Thank you very much. Make sure you do share this lecture with other students. God bless you all. I'll see you all soon tomorrow. Till then, enjoy your studies. Jai Hind.